Some of you may remember that last year I did a bunch of Batman reviews. Like, I reviewed a bunch of the Batman graphic novels, and I reviewed all the Tim Burton and Joel Schumacher Batman movies, and I reviewed all the Christopher Nolan Batman movies, and I reviewed the 1960s Batman with Adam West, and I did a review on the 1943 serial The Batman, which was basically the first on-screen adaptation of the Batman comics. But I realized that there was so much other Batman stuff that I did not touch upon. I realized that I did not review the 1949 serial entitled Batman and Robin last year, and also I didn't touch on any of the animated Batman movies, and I also didn't review. There were also a lot of other Batman graphic novels I did not review last year, so I figured this year I'll do more Batman reviews. So I'm starting these reviews out with the 1949 serial Batman and Robin. So yeah, this is my review on the 1949 serial Batman and Robin, not to be confused with the Joel Schumacher Batman and Robin from 1997. Now, Batman and Robin is basically a sequel to the 1943 serial entitled The Batman, which was really the first Batman movie, technically. If you would consider a serial to be a movie, in a way you can kind of consider a serial to be a movie in a way, now if you saw my review on The Batman from 1943, I mentioned how that was a pretty racist movie because it was made during World War II, and there was a lot of like World War II propaganda in that movie. Like, the main villain of the movie was a Japanese character, and they were constantly using phrases like "Japs" throughout that movie. This movie is definitely less politically incorrect, which is understandable considering World War II was over by this point. So there's like no propaganda in the movie. There's no like political agenda that this movie's trying to shove in your face, which is one of the reasons why I kind of liked this serial a lot better than the 1943 one. But yeah, I actually really enjoyed this one because the 1943 serial, The Batman, I honestly thought was kind of boring at parts, but this one definitely kept my interest more. It was a lot more fun in my opinion. So the plot of Batman and Robin is, it revolves around a villain called the Wizard, who, to my knowledge, isn't even a character from the comics. I believe he was just created for this serial, but basically this character called the Wizard steals this device, which gives him the power to control any moving vehicle he wants to. Like, this device gives him the power to control a bus, a train, or a car. Like, pretty much anything he wants to, he can control. So he tries using this to his advantage, and the main plot line is Batman and Robin now have to stop this character called the Wizard and find out who the Wizard really is, because throughout the whole movie you don't know who the Wizard actually is, and there are actually characters in it who you think might be the Wizard. Like, in the movie there's a reporter on the radio who keeps saying information over the air which he couldn't possibly know, so you think he might be the Wizard. Also there's the professor who there's this professor who made the device, and he's also somebody who you think might be the Wizard. So it's also kind of a mystery as well, and in the movie you see Batman actually doing detective work trying to figure out who the Wizard actually is, which is something that I thought was pretty cool about it. And also in this movie you get Commissioner Gordon, and this was actually the first time Commissioner Gordon ever actually appeared on screen, because he wasn't a character in the first one, The Batman, and this is also the first time you see Vicki Vale on screen as well, because Vicky Vale is also one of the characters in this movie. But, yeah, this is a really cool movie. It's a really fun serial. Now, there are some things that are easy to make fun of, like, probably this movie's biggest flaw, and this was also a flaw that the first one had, was the Batmobile is a car. Like, literally, it's a car. It's not the Batmobile. Literally, in this movie, Batman and Robin drive around in a car, like a convertible. It's freaking hilarious because it's also Bruce Wayne's car, and it's like Bruce Wayne is trying to conceal his identity, yet he's driving around in the same car. I find that to be absolutely hilarious. So there's definitely some things in this movie that are easy to make fun of. So it's very cheesy. But also I blame that a lot on its budget, because the movie does have a very low budget. But overall, it's a very fun serial. I would definitely recommend it. Now, it's in 15 parts, and you can actually watch this on YouTube. But I would recommend checking it out. It is a lot of fun. I would kind of recommend the first one, The Batman. Just keep in mind, the first one was kind of racist, and the first one is kind of boring compared to this one. But if you want, check out the first one, which is entitled The Batman. But personally, I recommend this one more. So, yeah, that's my review on Batman and Robin from 1949, and bye.